Hello everyone, this is Chris from Rakombu, a very sweaty Chris from Rakombu. I've just got off a really hot trim, straight from the OnePlus 5 launch event where we've got our hands on the final device in this lovely, sexy black box. We're going to do a full unboxing now and set up and everything as well so you can take an in-depth look at the new OnePlus flagship phone with us. So first of all, sorry if I kind of pass out halfway through this video. I did just get off a train that was about 300 degrees, so I'm feeling a little bit lightheaded. But the OnePlus 5 is also making me feel lightheaded because it looks amazing. Good segue, right? So here we go. This is obviously OnePlus's first 2017 phone launch, and it looks to expand on the brilliant OnePlus 3T, which was our favorite phone of 2016. In several areas, most notably the dual camera, which as you can see, they've obviously bigged up quite a lot. There's the full reviewer's guide there, explaining the new handset in full with all of its new features, design, and all the rest of it. Hey, cat action. Everyone loves a good pussy. Cheap joke there for the win. So there you go. So I'll go through that later. But here we go, the OnePlus 5. So as you can see, we've got the handset itself right here. And as you, if you're a OnePlus fan already, you'll notice that the box certainly hasn't changed in design much at all. It's the same box we know and love. Nice shiny white glossy finish, very subtle design, just the number 5 there, slightly embossed in the surface. Dual camera, clearer photos, of course. So again, continuing that message on both sides with the awesome new camera tech. And it's the midnight black one. Get in. Yes, win. So it comes in two colors. There's a kind of a slate gray version and the midnight black. The midnight black is the more beefy of the two, as well as spawning the sexier design in our own personal opinion. As you can see, created together with our fans, OnePlus fans are obviously very vocal and very smart, very clued up when it comes to tech and all the rest of it. I'd imagine there's a few watching now, so good on you guys. So there we go, there's the OnePlus 5 handset, and also in the box it looks like we've got some of the new cases. So as you can see, you've got the wood grain finishes, just like you did on the previous OnePluses, and also a sort of a more textured sandblasted kind of finish, and that looks like another sort of textured banded effort there. So we'll check all those out in full, most likely in another video. But now, onto the main event, OnePlus 5, here we go. Let's do a full unboxing. In terms of the sort of the specs and everything, most of the specs haven't changed too much from the OnePlus 3T. It's still the same size, it's still a 5.5 incher. Hang on, sorry, I'm gonna have to get something sharp to pierce this because my nails are shit. Definitely not sharp enough. Oh, God damn it. Ah, there we go. I ended up just chewing the thing. Often the way forward. So it's still a 5.5 inch handset, still a full metal unibody, as you'll see in a second once I pull it free. There we go, there it is in all of its glory. Gorgeous, and very black, as you might expect. We'll take a look at that in a second. First of all, because it's an unboxing, we'll check out the rest of the box. Okay, so that's very snazzy. Straight away, you get an example photo taken on the OnePlus 5. Shot by Gunkala Tixeria in Iceland. Sorry if I completely mauled your name, Gondera, as I probably did. Friend, thanks for choosing the OnePlus 5. We developed this device with the goal of making effortlessly clear photos for everyone. Smart technology, superior camera tech, such powerful tech, some amazing shots. So again, lots of stuff about the camera tech. That's from Kolpa himself, co-founder of OnePlus. On the other side of this card is one of my favorite photos. This is chosen by Carl himself. Good on you, Carl. I think that's probably the photo competition that OnePlus held to get hands-on with the device early. So as you can see, a bit of Type-C USB action. And as usual, a lovely vibrant red cable. You're not gonna be losing that one in the dark when you're fumbling around at 2 a.m. because you're sloshed and you need to charge your phone back up. We know what you're like, you dirty sods. 3-pin UK plug, hooray. And of course it's fully dash charge compatible, as you can see, for the obvious clue on the side there. So that should power you back up. They're running a full day's charge in just 30 minutes, I believe it was. So hopefully that will provide just that kind of performance. And that's it in the box, nice and straightforward, no headphones or any other shibaz? That's not a word, is it? Sorry, again, my brain is melting in the heat. I'm not used to this. I am northern, as you might have picked up from my twang. So definitely not used to any kind of sun or anything like that. Now the OnePlus 5. So as you can see, about the same sort of size as the OnePlus 3T and the rest of it. There was talk of them potentially trying out, you know, a more of a bezel-free design and all that kind of thing, but that would have just ramped up the cost unnecessarily. So instead they've stuck to a more sort of traditional design, but made a few lovely little refinements all the same, which we are going to cover ready now. Let's just see if I can peel off the sticker because that's rather ugly. There we go. Just all the serial number and the rest of it. So as you can see there, actually comes with a screen protector already installed as well, as you can see there. So hopefully that should provide a good bit of resistance against scratches and all the rest of it. It's actually more slender than previous OnePlus models, as you can hopefully see there. 7.25 millimeters in the end. So it is noticeably more slender than the OnePlus 3T. It's got this very nice, almost sort of unibody design with what they call the horizon separation, which basically is supposed to be partially in light, partially in dark, or whatever it was. They were talking a lot at the launch. A lot of it kind of went over my head when it comes to the design side of things. But as you can see, it's got an iPhone-style banding on it, below and above on the rear plate there, and just curves around neatly around the edges. And as you can see at the sides here, we've got the usual kind of controls. So we have, of course, the silent loud mode slider, alert slider, I believe it's known as. So you can stick it on full silent if you're about to slip into a meeting and take it back off when you get out. So that's a nice, convenient way of sticking it on vibrate. You also, of course, get the volume rocker. You get a power button over on the right edge, and of course the SIM tray just above that. Kind of hard to pick up some of this as it is the midnight black version, but hopefully you're making this all out all right. You've got a speaker down below there, nice metal grating there, Type-C USB and 3.5mm headphone jack. So don't worry if you've got old school headphones or earphones, you can still get those plugged in and get that top quality kind of audio experience. And of course, one of the major differences is, of course, the new dual lens camera. As you can see, it's no longer centrally positioned like it was on the OnePlus 3T and prior phones. It's now moved into this corner. That's just to kind of just to jumble around the insides and sort of make it all fit together. And you also, of course, get the two-tone LED flash right there as well. And as you can see, it barely juts from the surface, only ever so slightly juts, not too bad at all. So it's nice and streamlined, lovely. It does actually look very, very attractive indeed. Definitely your most favorite looking of all of the OnePlus phones to date. And of course, as I said before, you can pick it up in midnight black or in slate gray. Both handsets are made from full aluminium. They're not water resistant, unfortunately, no water resistance in the OnePlus 5, as we'd kind of hoped that we would get. To bring it more in line with other flagships such as the HTC U11, Samsung Galaxy S8 and S8 Plus, Sony Xperia XZ Premium and all the rest of it. But hey-ho, you can't have everything, can you? Hopefully it's got some charge already in it, and then we can start smashing out. Yes, and take you on a bit of a tour of the handset itself. Show you a bit about what it's all about. So yeah, as you can see, powered by Android, full Android Nougat with a bit of Oxygen OS thrown on top of it. So that adds a few bonus features. They didn't cover many of the features in the launch, but I know of a couple, which I will go through with you. Welcome. Not in the United States. We're on the United Kingdom. Not Espanol. English. United Kingdom. Thank you. Let's go. Hey ho. Let's skip the SIM card for now. I'll chuck that in later. Set up as a fresh phone. So I'm going to get connected to my network now. Just going to cut away for that. Okay. Phone's just checked for updates. And now we can sign into our Google account. We're just going to skip that for now as well, just so this video isn't 20 hours long. My name is not Joe Smith. It is Chris. I'm not going to type out my whole surname, which is Barrowclough, which takes about 3 hours. So I just put Chrissy B. Along with fingerprints. So of course, once again, you get a fingerprint sensor built in there in the home button beneath the screen. So let's just add that super quickly, along with the PIN number for added security. And if it's anything like the OnePlus 3T sensor, it'll be super, super, super responsive and accurate as well. It's one of the fastest scanners you can get. Unlocks the phone in like absolutely no time whatsoever. Basically, the instant you tap your thumb to the surface, which is great. So done. Google services, all the usual. Yes, you can have all my data, don't worry. User experience program you can join just to give OnePlus automatic feedback. All set. Yes, we're all good. Adding the finishing touches, then hopefully there we go into the OS itself. That was a really fast setup process. Really, really impressed so far. So 5.5 inch full HD AMOLED screen, exactly like the OnePlus 3T. As you can see here, if we just get in nice and close, we just pull up this the apps tray, as you can see, nice and crisp and vibrant as well. The AMOLED panel really lets the colors shine off the screen. Nice vibrant visuals, really, really love it. So even though it's not quad HD like a lot of the recent flagships, you're not really going to notice in everyday use. You know, full HD movies is still going to look fantastic. You will not notice any kind of grain or anything like that. And look at those colours; they really do shine off very nicely. On top brightness, you should have no problems either. Let's boost that right the way up. See, that's not even anywhere near top brightness. Oh my God, my retinas are literally smoking. No, they're not. That would be strange. Stop using literally when you don't mean it, kids. It's not cool. Neither is quizzing people on grammar, so I'll shut the hell up now. That's a 5.5-inch AMOLED screen. It now does have one bonus feature, which it didn't have before, which is the new reading mode, which hopefully will be dead easy to find. Hopefully it'll just be tucked away in display. Here we go, reading mode. So this is one of the new features of the new Oxygen OS. And what this basically does is it uses the ambient light sensor in order to detect the environmental conditions, and it automatically adjusts the color warmth, the color temperature, right there, just kind of like the night mode that automatically filters blue light, makes the colors nice and warm for more comfortable on the eyes, easy experience at night. So this is kind of the next evolution of that, I guess. It can alter the color warmth at any time, the color temperature. And as you can see, you can also add apps for the reading mode, which again, it's supposed to be particularly good for reading ebooks and the rest of it, hence the name. And again, just sort of makes the display that little bit warmer for a more natural, kind of like almost reading off paper kind of feel, which is really, really cool. So you can either manually activate it or automatically have it turned on when you're using specific apps. So that seems like quite a cool feature. We'll be testing that out in full. As you can see, you do get the standard night mode as well. Gonna boost the sleep time up. You've got adaptive brightness, of course, all the rest of it. Auto rotates, all the usual kind of stuff you would expect. Let's see what else we've got in here. So gesture support as well. As you can see, you can once again do a bit of gesture support, drawing on the screen when the phone is hibernating in order to launch up certain apps and the rest of it. So you're going to open the camera with a quick sketch of an O, start recording a video, open the shelf, etc., etc. And the same with various other letters as well. Double tap to wake, always a handy feature to have. Three finger screenshot as well, if you want to take a quick snap. Flip the phone over in order to mute it. So quite a few gestures there thrown in. Buttons, you can of course swap the buttons around down below. So you can have back and recent apps, you can swap those around. You can also have an on-screen navigation bar if you prefer that option. Long press and double tap action of the home button if you want to open up specific apps using that. So we're getting loads of gesture control. This is a great thing about Oxygen OS, is it does add a lot of great customization in there, which really, really does help out with just getting straight into the apps that you really like. So Snapdragon 835 is what powers this bad boy. Found in a few other phones right now, such as the HTC U11, Sony Xperia XZ Premium. It's gonna be nippy as hell. Like, there's no point in even being like, oh, let's see how fast it loads Chrome, because it's just gonna do everything instantly. It's stunningly powerful. Let's just bump down this the screen brightness a bit more, actually, because it's super, super bright. Don't wanna overpower it for the camera. And it's backed by, in this phone, 8 gigs of RAM, in the slate gray, 6 gigs. So either way, you're gonna get incredible performance. We'll do a full AnTuTu benchmark and the rest of it, but our previous AnTuTu benchmark with 835 has been really impressive. One of the best you'll get around right now. So this'll outperform most of the handsets out there. Not a problem. You get the 64, 128 gigs of storage, depending on which color you choose as well. Of course, the black model comes with more, 128 gigs in all. As you can see, only 626 megs have been used of 111, so you obviously don't get the full 128 available, because quite a lot is used up by the OS and the rest, but that's still enough to keep you going, shall we say. And of course, it's not expandable via microSD, unfortunately, but as you can see, there's 7.5 gigs of RAM available. And also, it's faster storage than the OnePlus 3T. OnePlus itself reckons about sort of 40% faster, I believe it was, they said. So it should be super, super fast for opening apps, reading your files and all the rest of it, especially good if you're reading high-res audio files, media files, all that kind of stuff. The memory is also faster as well, I reckon, 20% faster than the OnePlus 3T, so that should help your apps, again, to load super, super quick and to run really smoothly. Great stuff. It's a 3300 milliamp battery packed away inside. If you just dive back into the settings again and go to the power mode, you'll find the usual power modes there. OnePlus reckons you'll get easily, comfortably over a day of life per charge. We will, of course, be fully testing that out for our full OnePlus 5 review. But of course, as you can see there, you get battery optimization, so you can get certain apps. You can say, I don't want you using up all of my battery power in the background, thank you very much, and sort of disable all that. And battery saver mode as well, which can turn on automatically. So that's all good. Which I guess brings us onto the camera tech. We really need to obviously talk about this because this is the biggest update on the OnePlus 5 compared with previous phones. So as you can see, of course, it is a dual lens camera on the back. You get a 16 megapixel f1.7 aperture wide angle lens, backed by a 20 megapixel telephoto lens, which is f2.6, I believe it was. So in combination, they should shoot really sharp, detailed photos. Should be able to get a good zoom on it and all the rest of it. Obviously, great crispness as well, with the two lenses working in conjunction of each other. And with that f1.7 aperture as well, it should capture really, really crisp and grain-free low-light photos as well, touch wood. So far, certainly, it's making this room look a lot brighter than it actually is. Thanks to my daughter for all these little wall scribbles. Cheers for that. I suppose it is her room, so I can't really complain. As you see, just snap away, super, super fast autofocus, really, really nippy indeed. That definitely seems to be a rival to the likes of the Samsung Galaxy S8 and the Xperia XZ Premium, so it'd be better than the XZ Premium actually, which has a bit of processing time with it, unfortunately. And you get a few bonus modes, of course, you get full built-in HDR and all the rest of the stuff that you would expect. As you can see, if you flip up, you enter full video recording mode. You can shoot up to 4K resolution video just with a quick tap there. And of course, 60 frames per second, 1080p as well. Glorious stuff. If we dive into the settings, you can see you get a variety of different other modes as well. You get full manual controls. So as you can see there, you can mess around with the shutter speed, white balance, ISO levels, all the rest of it. Great stuff. And there we go. It's a nice little turny wheel. You just twist, twist, twist. There you go. And get it to exactly what you want if you're a bit of a pro, a bit confident with all of that. And you can shoot in full raw images as well, which is handy for editing on the go in particular, and captures lots of impressive detail. And of course there's a new portrait mode as well, which we're interested in checking out. Kind of similar, I'm guessing, to Huawei's portrait mode on its P10, P10 Plus. So what you do is basically it uses the two lenses in conjunction, and it just captures a nice sharp image and plenty of bokeh in the background as well. So I'll just find a willing subject. Okay, everyone, meet Molly. Hello, Molly. You are our willing victim in this quick test. So as you can see, we've got a bit of depth effect on the go. This is using the two lenses in conjunction to keep the subject nice and sharp while adding this sort of blurred bokeh effect in the background. So we just take a quick snap and then check out the results. See, there was a bit of processing time there, but as you can see, Molly is nice and sharp, but the background has got that sort of lovely, gorgeous sort of blurring effect. So it really helped Molly stand out. And that looks really nice. So a similar sort of effect, as we say, you can get on the likes of the P10 and the P10 Plus. So we'll be obviously testing that out in full. And around the front, you get 16 megapixel f2.0 aperture lens, which I'll not turn on now because you'll see me and how disgustingly sweaty and horrible I look. So that will just give you nightmares. Let's not do that. So there we go. That, in a nutshell, is the new OnePlus 5. A few other little bonus features that we haven't mentioned. There's a new gaming mode, for instance, which is similar to Samsung's game launcher. And a few other little tweaks here and there. But we'll be covering the Oxygen OS in full, so stay tuned for all that. And of course, comparing this bad boy to lots of other flagship phones, including the old OnePlus 3T, Samsung Galaxy S8, Sony Xperia XZ Premium, and the Google Pixel. So stay tuned for all of that. Thanks for watching, everyone. Love you. Bye.